Hi guys, welcome to part 23 of Angular 8 video tutorial series by TechTechTuts in 2020. In today's Angular 8 video tutorial, we will learn about child routes as well as we will see how can we protect our child routes, that certain child route can be accessed by the certain users, not every user. So hopefully you will watch this video tutorial till the end, and if you like it, don't forget to press the like button. And if you are new to our channel TechTechTuts, then don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon so that you will get notifications whenever I upload a new video. So with that request, let's get into the video tutorial. So this is our previous video tutorial where we learned that how can we create protected routes. So this dashboard, it will only work when the user is logged in. If user is not logged in, it will be redirected back to login page. So for example, currently check it true. So if I make it false, then user cannot access this dashboard anymore. It will be redirected back to the login screen. So you see login works. So if I connect about, home or contact, it's working fine. But if I try to access dashboard, it is not working. So suppose that the user is logged in. So now user will access further two more components. So within dashboard we need to create routes. So same route which we have created in app.component, I will copy it and then I will paste it here. I only need two components, so they are in slash dashboard slash home, not home, basically users, and slash dashboard slash profile. So this is users and this is profile. So any logged in user can access the profile, but only admins can access the users. So in the current scenario, we cannot use can activate. We need to create another scenario which is called can activate child, or we need to create another guard which will only guard this users for the logged in users. So, but we can achieve this using can activate as well. So one scenario is to use can activate child. So for that, let me modify our app module routes. So here inside this dashboard, I will create some children's. So children. So make sure when you create children, the first child which you want to protect with can activate must work like this path, colon, colon. Sorry, first we need curly brackets, then path, and then empty space. Then here you will put another component, not component, basically we will put children here again. So here we will put path, and then I will put here users, and component will be users component. And users cannot find users component. Okay, I will create that users component right now. So ng generate component users. So it will import this users component here. So there you go. Now if I users component, it will import automatically. And now this children of this dashboard, I can protect whatever component I create here. I can protect them using can activate child. So I can put here can activate child, and then I will put auth guard, the same component, and then whatever I put in this array of children, it can be protected. But here I will put comma and I will put path, and here I will show profile. So the component will be profile component. So ng generate profile. So make sure when you create child components, you can activate them, and then when you put children which are under can activate child, they must work like this. They must be under path with empty string, and then you put activate can activate child, and then you put children in it, and then here you can put all your routes which you want to protect with can activate child. So now component, and here I will put profile component, and that's it. This profile component is part of this dashboard, so that means it can be accessed. So save it, and this one is saying I will override. So okay, we will override it, and then inside dashboard component.html we need to add a router outlet. So this router outlet will work for these child components. They will be displayed here. That's it. That's why I'm adding router outlet child here inside this dashboard.component.html. So now inside athguard.ts file, we need to implement can activate child. So first of all, we need to import can activate child from Angular router, and then we need to implement it can activate child, and then I will copy this function and paste it here, and then I will just name it can activate child. The rest is almost same. So now we can make it true false here. So this one is true. Then I will redirect it to the dashboard slash profile. So if user is false, means check is false, then user will be redirected to the profile page. Otherwise it will be redirected to the users page. So whatever you have added inside this, these links can be accessed. So let's see, whenever we have some issue running here. So let's see what is the issue. I will open inspect and then go to console. Let me put it down below. So inside the console, let me see if there is cannot component. User component is not part of any ng module. So what it's actually saying, that user component is not imported here. So let me user component and profile component, let me add them inside app module.ts. this time I think the error will be gone. So there you go, it will be reloaded. Okay, so now our dashboard is working. So inside dashboard we have further two routes, which are the child routes, users and profile. If I click on profile, it says profile works. If I click users, you see it is redirecting us to the profile. So even if I want, I can redirect it to the home page. So here inside app module not in authguard, I can redirect it to home component. Let me see if it works. I will redirect. I don't think so. If I navigate it to home, let's see, it will re-render, I think, because this is a single page application. So if I click users, yeah, now it's navigating me back to the home. So about, home, and then dashboard, profile is working but users is not working. So you can redirect it to wherever you want. Even dashboard slash profile is proper, because user is already logged in, that's why he can access the dashboard, and we are not redirecting it to the login screen. Otherwise you can redirect it anywhere you want. So user, you cannot access right now the users, but if you go and put can activate child true here inside guard, make the check true, then of course you can access. After this, now you can access users link as well. Let's see. You see, now we can access both users and profile links. So this is how can activate child will work. You need to put all of your components which you want to protect with can activate child under the links where you want to display the router outlet. So here I'm showing the router outlet on dashboard component. So that's why I have put the children in it, and within the children I created another empty path, which is a root path, and where I put can activate child key value pair with the auth guard, and furthermore I put children in it. So whatever children you put under this, like users and posts, so if I don't want to allow the posts as well, so that I can create here under this children component, and that particular route will not be accessed until user is logged in or authenticated as an admin. So this is it. This was our video tutorial for today, where we learned about how to create child routes, how can we create can activate child guard, and we can protect our child route as we like and as we want. So guys, thank you very much for watching this video tutorial. Take care and goodbye.